let's try to solve a numerical in this experiment. I'm talking about in this experiment, what is the distance of closest approach to the nucleus for 7.7 MeV alpha particle before it momentarily comes to rest and reverses its direction. The atomic number of the gold is given as, you remember gold's atomic number? I think it's 79. Yeah, 79. The atomic number of gold is given as 79. Try this. The hint is you have to use conservation of energy. Done? See, you have a nucleus . The closest approach happens when it is a head-on collision, by other way it will just deflect and go away. So if the alpha particle starts to move towards the nucleus, okay, how much charge it has? 2 times the charge of the electron. How much charge nucleus has? 79 times charge of the electron. It has 79 protons in it. Fine. Initially, this has a kinetic energy of this much. And potential energy between this and that is 0. Then suppose it comes very close. This is the distance of closest approach. I can say that this is the distance r. The potential energy between this charge and that charge you can write down. Okay, so basically all you have to do is sum up potential energy and kinetic energy initially and equate it to potential energy and kinetic energy finally. Okay, what is the final kinetic energy? 0. It comes to rest. Fine. Initial potential energy is what? 0. They are infinitely separated from each other. So it is 0 and initial kinetic energy is 7.7 MeV. So this is 7.7. Mega is 10 to the power 6 electron volt, as in you have to multiply charge of the electron. This is U1 plus K1. This should be equal to what? U2 plus K2. U2 is what? K times Q1 Q2 by R plus 0. K is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Okay, get it quickly. What is R? K is 9 to 10 to the power 9. Q1 is 2E. Q2 is 79E. This into 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. Divided by R, that is equal to 7.7 10 to the power 6 into charge of the electron. So this E is go. Okay. There will be one more E that is coming in, the E square, right? Okay, so when you simplify, you will get the value of R as 3 into 10 to the power minus 14. Which is actually 30 ferrimeter, or sorry, 30 femtimeter. Okay, but in actual case, the radius is 6. The radius of the gold foil, this thing, is 6. So the alpha particle never touches the gold nucleus. It comes that far and then moves away. Using conservation of energy, you can actually find out, if you know the radius of the gold nucleus, what energy is required by the alpha particle to touch the gold nucleus. That also you can find out. Fine, so this is all about the atoms in general. In general. Okay. Now we are going to talk about electrons. Going forward, our study is electrons, the behavior of electrons. Why not the nucleus? Because there is a separate chapter on the nucleus. The next chapter of modern physics is nuclei only. Okay? So our focus right now is electrons. Fine. Write down electron orbits. So now the situation is pretty clear that at the center there is this positively charged particle which is called nucleus, and around it the electron will revolve. Fine. So the picture looks like this. There is this nucleus. Fine. And the electron will revolve around it. Right. Try to draw a circle. I am talking about right now hydrogen atom. Hydrogen atom, okay, not hydrogen molecule. Single this thing. So there is one electron that is moving. Let us say the speed is v. It moves in a circular orbit. Fine. Now if anything has to move in a circular orbit, what should be its acceleration? It is uniform circular motion, speed is constant, so acceleration is? No. There will be an acceleration towards the center, centripetal acceleration. Okay? So there will be a radial or centripetal acceleration of the value v square by r. Okay? Where r is the radius. So if there is an acceleration, I mean this thing you know, right? If anything has to move in a circle, its radial acceleration should be v square by r. That should be known. Okay. Now if that is the radial acceleration, does it mean there should be a force also? If there is an acceleration, there should be a force. How much? Mass into acceleration. So there should be a force along the direction of acceleration, which is radial. That force should be equal to mass into acceleration. So mv square by r. So there should be a force that creates this mass into acceleration. What is the force here? What it is? Electrostatic force. Force of attraction. Fine. Like for example, when Earth revolves around the sun, what is the centripetal force? Gravitational force. There should be a centripetal force if something is moving in a circle. Fine. So this is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Q1, Q2 is E square only, because the nucleus also has the same charge as that of electron. So this is E square by R. Is this clear? Okay. This comes by force balancing. This is actually R square, so one of the R get cancelled. Fine. In the electrostatic force, divided by R square comes. Fine. So you will get mv square is equal to what? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught E square by R. Okay. Now, what is kinetic energy of the electron? This is what? This is mass of electron only. Right? So, kinetic energy of the electron will be how much? Half into mass of electron into V square. Which is equal to what? Half of 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught a square by r. Fine. This is kinetic energy. What about potential energy? How much is the potential energy between electron and the nucleus? How much it is? Electrostatic potential energy? You don't know. You forgot electrostatic, huh? Completely. Potential energy is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. We just used it, na? That distance of closest approach. Q1, Q2 by distance between the two charges. In this case, what will be it? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into?
E square.
No. Minus E square. One is positive charge, other is negative charge. Fine. So this is potential energy. Okay. Let us call it PE because kinetic energy is KE. It is better to call it PE. So this is potential energy. Okay. Now, what is total energy? KE plus PE. Right. So if you add these two, 1 and 2, you will get a total energy, fine. That will come out to be equal to minus of half. Is this thing clear? Huh? Total energy is a negative quantity. It is negative. Now if electron leaves the nucleus, what will be the energy? Zero. It goes to infinity. Energy will be zero. Right now it is negative. So will it leave the nucleus? It will not. Because its energy is already less. Lesser than what it would have been had it leave. If it leaves, energy will increase. And every object wants to have as less energy as possible. It is already less. So why it will leave the nucleus? Are you getting my point? Fine. So how much energy you have to give for it to leave the nucleus? This much energy if you give, add it, it becomes zero. Fine. So this energy can be referred as binding energy. This much energy is holding the electron with the nucleus. Okay. And now you can also create a formula for yourself that total energy is equal to minus of kinetic energy is equal to half of potential energy. Fine. So if I just tell you one of the energies, the other two you should be able to get it immediately. Fine. Any doubt on this? Anything? No? This thing you have done in chemistry also? Write down. It is found that 13.6 electron volt energy is required to separate hydrogen atom into proton and an electron. It's like taking away electron from the hydrogen. You need this much energy. Calculate the radius of the atom and velocity of the electron. Did you get the answer? Lot of calculation is there. Everybody knows how to solve, but difficult to calculate. Much smaller than nucleus itself. This is a total energy. Fine. So if you have to give this much energy for electron to leave, so if you add this much, how much it should become? This should become zero. minimum energy required for this to leave the nucleus. So when it leaves, energy becomes zero. Getting it? So one electron will get cancelled from here. So from here you will be able to calculate what is R. Okay? The answer for R is 5.3 into 10 to the power minus 11. Did you get anything?
I got 5.3.
You got 5.
I got 5.3. Power is. I got 28.
Power is the easier thing to get. Anyway, how will you get velocity? See, kinetic energy is how much? Kinetic energy is negative of this, negative of total energy. So half times 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught E square by R. Once you get the value of R, you can substitute it here. But good thing is the value of this is known. How much this? 13.6 E. This is this entire thing. Isn't it? This plus this, if it is 0, then this should equal to that.
Yeah.
So this should be equal to half mv square, mass of electron into velocity square. Mass of electron is 9.1 10 to the minus 31. Fine, so from there you get the velocity of the orbit.